You ready?
I'm a city with that rapping. They know I make it happen. I ain't rapping. I'm on dope paint and I'm acting.
Let's
yeah, this me.
Let's go.
And I smash them. Pop your toe with daddy's up and stash it. Can't so back together. Daddy, you're dead. With that black beretta. Running out with $1 million cash with my puncher. I want that shit and make it flash because it's smoke better. Racks on them. Racks, I should do it better. Racks, that in. I put his on top of stretch. I'll rob you on the second time I met you. Talk about beef and when I meet you, greet you with a blitz. Man, I hate him. I once had to shoot him. But I say it like it. I had them young niggas in your yard waiting in your bush. Young and pop out waiting with the run and he trying to cook it. I'ma act bad and I'm gon' flash off these data jiggers. Get in my feelings by my cousin and we married him. Shut off the rep, that's if he's swearing with you. Claim that he really knows who he is, you got him saying. I'm a big truck, what? Roll out some pills inside the field, I cannot slip up. We don't give no play, we tryna kill something. Try to get my cut your mama, let me feel something. Hurry to be doing no things.
And as you can see, we got a show for you guys. All right, I'm Justin. I'm the cameraman for this little action we got going on. And I just wanted to dive a little bit more deep of what we got. So you're going to see it's a little bit of a sentimental moment right here. Coach Sosa, mother died a year ago. And they were giving her a little memorial service at this first game. So we're just going to kind of let him touch on and see, show you guys how he felt about that.
Hold on, they ain't going nowhere, bro. Lock us out, bro.
Keep on moving up.
Now with this first game, we seen that they were trying to put their foot on the gas the whole time. So this is the first play, not too much. Got about a good 11-yard carry.
They steward sections be crazy.
But here's where it gets crazy. I missed the first part of the play. QB kicks man miss, and he starts to take off for our first score. Winton Woods goes up 6-0. And these boys are looking to clown the rest of the night. So you see this little snippet of Justin and Coach Sosa. Well, they had a quick 3-and-out, and they moved it. They moved that offense out of there. But we're looking at first place from scrimmage after the 3-and-out. And look what his back doing. Get off. Nope, Stiffy. I'm out of here. Oh, wait. The cameraman's right there, dog. Oh, all right. I got knocked out of the play, y'all. But it doesn't matter. Winton Woods with another touchdown. They go up 14-0. Now I know what you're thinking. Finally. Justin on some mic'd up clip. Here he goes getting his first tackle.
All right.
back on offense. Let's see what we got here. Oh, we had the bowling ball 26. This man was rumbling and tumbling. He was not taking no for an answer. Get off me. I have to get to the end zone. I am going to the end zone. Get off of me. Look at that. I'm so close, coach. I got like 5 yards. Now, we all know how this works. If a running back makes a big carry and barely gets towards the end zone, he's getting the ball again. Give me the ball. Touchdown. I told y'all I was getting in this end zone. That's 6 again.
He was sick all last week.
I know.
Defense, let's go. Let's go.
They gonna give that boy 26 another carry. Give that man 2. With that score, Winton Woods went up 28-0. And as you guys can see, this blowout is getting out of hand. But let's watch Justin make some plays before we go anywhere.
At 51, just let me get a sack real quick, buddy. I'll leave him off the F and
on top of a number 99.
Yeah, Donnie said I was good. Matthew Palmer. Hey, bro. Are we close to like the same height?
Number 2, Charles Johnson.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
You got to get to number 3. If I'm at Mike and number 3 is going straight, I got to get to him like this. Because that's literally why we worked on shuffling today, so that I could shuffle out. And while I'm shuffling, I could read it.
Come on. That was your pick, bro.
Hey, he was talking about it.
I thought he was going.
And that one's going to make it 35-0 before halftime. I know you guys are getting tired of these one little clips and the offense is back on the field, but let me ask y'all something. Y'all think they were doing anything on offense? Nothing. And now it's 42-0 at half.
Touchdown, Warriors!
They hit the...
PG picked up the end.
It just looks so much different. Come on, y'all. It's 3:16 on the clock. He back there. Hurry, look at Murph. Rallo, you might get the... You might get the jug tonight.
Y'all know it's bad if coaches are talking to freshmen. Like, hey, y'all really going to get the spin.
So you could look like 20 foot tall.
And I'm wearing my sixes. No motherfucking man, I'm 6'3".
Can't say I don't try.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah, Murph.
Estimate time.
I'm going to give it a little
now,
look.
Sadly,
3 minutes and a second.
I'm pretty sure this is the last time we see our man. He gets pulled out before halftime, and he doesn't come back in. So we're just going to listen to Sosa as he talks up his defense for a little bit.
Come on, Rayel. Oh!
Josh went the wrong way.
Josh!
Broken up by number
wrong two, way! That's false start!
Penalty flag.
That's false start! He can't do that. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The reason I dropped over there is because it was trips to the field side, so I knew there wasn't really no good.
So you still just got to respect my job. I still open up there, and I take that step, not seeing nothing, then I just get back even. Or I flip all the way back over. So I got to do my job. I got to play the coverage. I got to do my job, and I got to play the coverage. That's it.
Gave them all.
Besides the JV guys. Yeah. That's cool.
That's where we can get in there and get to work. We're good.
So let me tell you what this conversation is. Hey, Coach Sosa, you putting any of the JV guys in? Yeah, Coach, we already started rotating them in. We'll start putting the freshmen in because we just beating the dog down their legs. And that's pretty much how that game ended. Winton Woods finishes us up 49 to nothing. Now let's move on to our game two, the real matchup. Revenge tour.
Hey, mask up, mask up. Oh, again. All right.
Oh, shit. Y'all already
know this. Let's go. Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah.
You got it. You ready? Hold on, hold on.
You ready?
So let me explain to you guys what I mean by a revenge tour as we have our Winton Woods cheerleaders come by. Last year, Winton Woods meets with Kings in the regular season and has an easy win, takes them out, and they end up going to the playoffs and having another meeting. Now, Winton Woods discussed with me that they thought they were going to just go in there, waltz in, and take the dub, easy money. Well, Kings was not going. Kings is known for being a very good defensive team, and with that, they ended up taking them out of the playoffs in their state run. So, Winton Woods feels like this one's personal.
Come on, we gotta get this. We gotta get this.
Give me luck.
Hey.
So with that pressure, our boy causes a sack and causes another three and out, and this game is starting off hot. Now, let's get back to the offense, where these guys were trying to take the top off as soon as they could. And look at this, a big bomb downfield, and Ryan, that we introduced y'all to earlier, comes down with the TD grab, and this man starts off his field goal.
Watch the run!
And our man Justin is starting early, getting his first tackle for a loss in the second drive. Now, Kings wasn't soft. They weren't going for that, so they throw a quick curl, get them a first down, but that doesn't stop Justin from getting his first sack of the night.
Hey.
Tuck in. They're finna start doubling. They're finna start doubling. Zay! Go! Zay! Go! Zay! Zay!
Now, offense, they were having themselves a little bit of a slow start after the touchdown, looking for something over the top, but looks like they couldn't find their man. But King's defense wasn't nothing to play with either, as they start and force their own sack, forcing the Winton Woods offense to get off the field, giving their offense another shot. See, but when you have a freakish athlete like this, you can only keep him away for so long. Jay Hill gets it second.
Come on.
Hey, G-Boy, G-Boy, they can't block y'all.
Don't
they
let them score, bro.
Keep going, they can't block y'all. They can't fuck y'all.
They don't deserve to score.
Thank Coach Sosa for that little defensive insight. Now let's check out the offense. A carry for nothing. Let's see what we can do over the air. Ball's up, and it's picked off. All right, this is looking like a great defensive game. Now with King's offense on the field, let's see what they can do. Quick catch. Oh, get off me. You can't touch me. All right, let's try to get into this end zone. Oh. All right, I ain't touched the end zone, but I'm close. Come on, Coach, give me the ball again. I got it. Now Coach Sosa's trying to contain everything in him because he knows that was a linebacker that just missed that tackle. And like we said, King's was close. Wait, is that a Wildcat formation? The Wildcat formation is in. And number 30 dives across and gets him in the end zone. Look. Winton Woods doesn't let a loss be a complete loss as they block the field goal and stay up 7-6. Now let's get back to the offense. After a short carry and a high snap, looks like the QB is going to keep this one and get a short gain on it. Man, this offense is looking for any ways to move on the ground. King's defense was holding it to them, and they weren't stopping. Another sack by this King's defense. With the PI call, Ryan gets his second catch. At this point is in a chess match trying to line Justin up anywhere. Right now they got him over the tackle and center, just trying to find a way to get their best pass rusher in the backfield again. After starting the second or the first half with two sacks, they weren't letting my man get a one-on-one fight again after that. But like I told you earlier, you can only hold an athlete like this back for so long. He fights off a double team and forces another pressure. This man was eating all night. Didn't take one guy, two guys, three guys, throw the whole line at him. Number eight is going to find his way in the backfield some way. But like I told y'all, Kings aren't no scrubs. They get a big gain, convert the first down after a couple pressures, and they're looking to touch this end zone again.
Come on.
And there Kings does it. Go ahead and get in the end zone. And looks like they're going for two to try to take a 14-7 lead. But after the failed conversion, Kings only goes up 12-7 at the half.
Y'all having a good game. We just gotta fix mistakes, bro. We gotta fix mistakes. That's all.
Make plays, pound the rock. Hey, Warriors on three, Warriors on me. 1, 2, 3,
come on, KOR.
Go, boys. And after that short halftime break, let's get back to the action. The offense is looking to move downfield and takes a sack to start the first half. Defense forced a three and out, and offense got a three and out. They look to punt the ball and get defense back on the field to hold them to another scoreless drive.
Hit him, run! Stop waiting for it, TJ!
Hey, y'all want to check it? No, it's not. No, it's not. No, it's not. On your air. Air. Come on, bro. Hey, watch this home in. Get him on the ground.
After catching a couple good carries, they look to get something, but 99 isn't having it. Forces a sack, and this defense is looking to get a stop right before these guys get in the red zone. Offense gets another first down, but follows it up with a crazy option call that ends up resulting in a fumble that makes them lose about 8-10. After a couple tries, that man gets in the end zone, and Winton Woods is up 13-12. Now, naturally, I'm an offensive guy. I played offense. I love offense. But leaving my man's mic'd up with the final drive on defense, it's all you can ask for. And look, on the first play, he makes the quarterback step up and forces the sack.
Hey, hey, what? You're playing in the... Come on, bro. Stop.
Boom! That weak ass penalty!
Come on, good.
It all comes down to this. A fourth down play, the offense, our man Jay Hill mic'd up. Let's see what happens. And right here ends up being the nail on the coffin. They get a carry, get the first down, and your Winton Woods Warriors win 13-12.
Can't lose that. Can't
hold it. Justin Hill.
What was your mindset?
Nice game. Ultimately, just getting the win. I mean, we came in last year and beat them in the regular season, and they beat us. And I was heartbroken for like a month straight. So I'm super happy to get this win. But the goal is to execute. I've been into this. And I want to have a day myself and step up for the team.
What was the toughest thing about it?
Really, I had a good tackle in front of me, and he gave me challenges all night. I wanted to make more plays than I did, but I'm happy with the goal. Obviously, they shouldn't have scored, but things happen. So.
What is one thing that you learned?
That I just gotta stay humble. I mean, I learned that playing teams in general. I mean, we our head was so big playing them in the playoffs last year, so we just thought we was gonna blow past them. Today we thought we was gonna blow past them, and they gave us a tough game, and we barely won. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.